Hi guys, welcome to the world of 28mm. I'm Adam, and this week we are going to be taking a look at some more roads, specifically cobblestone roads. Okay, so you're going to need some blue foam, a bit of filler, a bit of pen, and a sharp knife. Okay, so let's head down to the table and crack on. See you in a sec. Okay, so first things first, a little bit of prep before we start sort of creating anything. You'll find with these long thin pieces that when you start painting and things like that, you might find some warping takes place because they are long and thin. Okay, so to combat this, what I've done is underneath these roads I have pre-taped them with some brown parcel tape. Now essentially what this will do is if you put this on before you start painting or anything, this tape has no give in it. So it won't stretch or anything like that, expand or shrink. So if you put a layer of this underneath, when you come to paint the actual road itself, you're going to reduce the risk of warping because this the tape has no give underneath. Okay, so that's the tape. So we need to strengthen this one up first. So you can see here I've beveled the edge so that the road will transition quite nicely into your board, and also if you get the gradient right, your model should sit nicely on the side without falling over and things like that. Okay, so to strengthen this one up is we're going to take some filler, my good old trusty, and then we're not going to do the whole road, we'll just do the side bits, the beveled pieces. Okay, so I'm just going to get a little bit of filler and just go across the edge like that. Okay, and that this will get rid of the foam texture that you get when you cut into this stuff. It'll cover up any mistakes that you may have made when cutting the bevel edge, because I did. Okay, and we're just going to do that to both sides. And like I say, this will just help add to the strengthening of the structure. That little bit that escaped there. There we go. Don't worry about getting it on the actual road or anything like that. Okay, so get that off my finger. So that's the road section sort of strengthened for the time being. I'm going to put that one to one side and let that dry, and I'll see you in a sec when it is. Okay, so while that one's drying, we'll work on this one. Okay, so this is going to be an extremely basic cobble road. What I'm going to do first of all is I'm just going to take this sharp edge off. We don't want to take too much, it's literally just a nothing is really that square. So if we take off this sharp edge, it will just help sort of blend it in. You see I'm hardly taking anything off, it's just taking this edge off. Work in thin slivers. Okay, and we'll just take these edges off. And last little bit. Cutting towards myself is always a great idea. There. Okay, so we've just taken that sharp edge off. Now, as I was saying earlier, all this really is to engrave your foam, and this would count for anything if you're doing wall sections or anything like that. All you really need is a biro, Okay, so what we're going to do is, first of all, we're going to mark out the paving area. Okay, so it was 3 inches, so let's go 1/4 inch in from each side. So I'll put a mark there, and I will put a mark there. I know you probably more than likely can't see these marks, one because my hands are in the way, but you'll see them in time. Okay, so we've got our marks there, and I'll just mark it at the top as well, just to so we can make sure these lines are right. So there's there and there. Okay, so let's join up those two lines that we've just made, if I can find it. Yep, there we go. And we're just going to draw one straight line, bring the angle the pen so it's straight up, and then we're just going to engrave. Go very slowly so that you don't like rip the blue foam or anything like that. There. Okay, so we've got one of our pavements marked out. Okay, so now that's all dry, we can do a second take because apparently the camera didn't film it the first time round. So what we're going to do now is we're going to make some cobbles. Okay, and all we need to do this is a Bic pen. When you're making your road sections, to make them blend in together when you put them all into one sort of road set, make sure on your edges of the road that you do half cobblestones rather than whole cobblestones. Okay, try and keep that theme going across it, and then your roads, no matter which way around you put them, should meet up. Okay, so just to show you quickly, I'll just do some on here. So like I say, just half cobblestones. Make sure you make them irregular, because there aren't very many cobblestones there, all the roads there, all the same size cobbles. And there, when you're happy with the, I'll show you in a sec, when you're happy with the, your initial layer of cobbles, then just go back over it with the pen and make sure all those joins join up together nicely, because you will be able to tell the difference when you like dry brush it and stuff. Okay, so there's our first line of cobbles. Okay, and after that we're just going to carry on building, and we're going to do another line underneath it or on top of it, whichever way you're looking at it. Okay, and once again, when you're happy with the stone itself, just go back over the previous line from the last line of cobbles, if that makes sense. You can see, hopefully you can see what I'm doing on the camera. But once again, that just ensures that all of these cobblestones are continuous, I guess. Okay, so I'll just do one line so you guys can see. Okay, and there we have our second row of cobbles. Okay, so I'm gonna do this entire road now. As for this one, let's bring this one back over. What I've done, you can't see it on the camera, which is a bit frustrating, but I've marked out going down the side of this road 1 millimeter bricks. Okay, and don't draw an entire line, because these things, unless you want them to be like dead straight, they're not. So just mark out the 1 millimeter lines going down each side. Do it each side, but rather than using a ruler, just freehand it from line to line, and that will make sure that all of your the stones are irregular and they won't quite look right, or they will look right. That's what you want. Okay, so I've got a line here. Right, and once again, I know you can't see it. Sorry, guys. I should do it with a Sharpie or something. Okay, but I've got a line here, and I'm just gonna roughly draw a straight line, or a rough straight line, across the road. Make sure not to go onto your little the paving bit, you know, the curb, shall I say, that you've just made. And then I'm going to roughly draw the next millimeter marked line. So from down here. There. And then we're just going to go through the middle and just do relatively straight lines. And then on the pavement as well, and one there we go. Okay, so there's our first line of bricks, and I'm going to do the same as the cobble. I'm going to just go across the whole thing. Okay, so I'll get that done and I'll see you guys in a minute. Right, so we're all engraved. You can see here we've got our cobblestone road. See how they're all engraved with those smooth plaster edges. Don't know whether you noticed or not, this is actually a different piece to what I was doing earlier. It had a big thumbprint in it and I wasn't happy with it, so just redid another one quickly. Okay, and then we've got our brick cobbles. Hopefully, yeah, you can see them. Okay, all right, and as you can see, we've got a nice sort of irregular shape. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to paint these up differently. So this one I'm going to do a flat grey. I've got some just normal emulsion. It's a Storm Cloud from Wilko's. So we're going to use this one on the on this one. Okay, so just nice thin layer over the top. Don't go too thick because you'll end up filling in all those little engraving marks you've done. Make sure you're getting all the nooks and crannies and stuff. We want this thing to be a nice flat grey by the time we're done with it. Don't worry, I'm not going to paint the whole thing in front of me. I know you guys know how to paint. Okay, so we've got a flat grey going on to that one. And then on our cobblestone one, we are going to use the dirt brown that I like using on, that you've seen me use on my farm board. If you haven't seen that, go and check it out. Okay, but we're going to give this one a simple brown undercoat like this. Base coat, shall I say, not undercoat. I think my boiler's about to go to the moon. Okay, once again, don't go too heavy because you don't want to fill in all those cracks that you've done. and do the sides as well while you're at it. Okay, so there's that one. So I'm gonna paint both of these now, and then we'll come back and we'll do the next part. Okay, so I'll see you guys in a sec. So here we are the next day. They're all dry, and I did actually have to give both of them a couple of coats just to cover up that black. But right, so next up we're gonna put a couple of washes on them just to go into all the cobbles that we've made. Okay, so what we're going to do, we've got a black wash here, and it's just a bit of black paint, some water, and a bit of washing up detergent. I'm just going to take our brush, I'm just going to put it onto this one here, and this will run into all of the little cracks between the bricks, and you'll start seeing a bit of the detail pop out. Okay, so there you go, there's that one. And then just quickly, I've got a wash again, but this one's made a burnt umber wash. Okay, and we're just going to use this one and get a nice bit of coverage. Oh, too much on my brush. Nice bit of coverage over this road here. Okay, you might not see a lot of difference because you are putting brown on top of brown, just different shades. But this is just to pop all of those cobbles out. Okay, so I'm going to go over both of these and just give them both a wash, and then we'll come back when it's done. Okay, see you in a sec, guys. Okay, so our washes have dried. Excuse me, sorry. And we can see here it's picked up the detail quite nicely. Okay, so, and with our regular cobblestones. So what we're going to do now is we're just going to put one or two highlights on this just to bring out the actual stones themselves. So we'll start on the cobblestone road first. Now what I've got here is some of the original brown that I used, excuse me, and I put a little bit of cream in it, and it's just so, like I say, we can dry brush it on and it'll bring out those highlights, bring out the cobblestone, sorry. Okay, so a bit on our brush, and we're just gonna pop those stones back out again. Actually probably more of an overbrush than it is a dry brush. Okay, so there's our first set there. Okay, I'm just gonna, I'll put that to one side and I'll go through it in a sec and just pop it all out again. Okay, so that's our first highlight, just the original brown, the bit of cream mixed in it just to lighten it up a bit. Okay. Okay, so while the other cobblestone is drying, we'll just do the same thing with this. What's that? Got a bit of a plastic on there. We're going to take the original storm cloud grey that we used as the undercoat or base coat. Okay, and we're going to dry brush this on. This, like the urban road, might take a few passes to make it pop properly, but you don't want to use an overbrush like I did with this cobblestone, because it will fill in all of these tiny little cracks, which we really don't want to do. We've spent so much time putting them in there that it would be a shame to lose them again. Hopefully you can see this coming out on camera. I'll hold it, I'll just finish off this little bit and then I'll hold it up to the camera so you can see it. Okay, so there's the first section sort of highlighted. Okay, so I'm going to go over and do the same with all of the same again, and then all I'm going to do after that is I'm going to highlight this again with a bit of the cream that I used to lighten up the brown. Okay, this one's called Crushed Almond. So I'm going to dry brush it with this grey just to make the stones pop, and then I'm going to dry brush it with this cream to make them pop even more. Alright, and then this one, after this first dry brush is dry, we're just going to add a bit of that crushed almond as well and just highlight the top. Okay, so I'll be back in a minute when I've done that. Yeah, I'll see you guys in a sec. Right, so they're all dry brushed up. Now just a couple more things left to do just to finish these off and bring a bit more life to them. Over to my right here, I've made up a watery green and a watery orange like we did for the urban roads. If you haven't seen that, go and check it out. It's on the roads playlist. And then we're just gonna let's do this one first. Then we're just gonna come in with a little bit of washed green and just douse it in places. Try and randomize it as much as you can so it doesn't look too uniform. Just get a bit more paint on my brush. To get these sort of random effects, you're better off stippling it onto the piece rather than you're painting it, because if you paint it you tend to sort of follow a line. So sorry, throwing my chain of thought off, someone just sent me a text message. So right, there we go, we've got our green, and then without washing off our brush I might just sort of dab it off on there. We're going to go into the orange. I'm going to do the same thing. Just going to put a bit of orange around. Oh, that was caught. Let's have a bit down here and a little bit of green as well. There we go. Oh yeah, right. Okay, I know that looks very bold on camera, but as the water dries it will tone it down and it'll be very subtle by the time it's done. Okay, so we'll put this to one side. Okay, so while that one's drying, we're gonna put some finishing touches onto this one. So I've got some watered down PVA here. Okay, it's been the same pot I've been using for my entire build. Okay, and we're just going to flock the sides of this up. Okay, so we're just going to come in with a bit of watered down PVA. Get a nice coverage along where you've put the plaster. Don't go onto your cobbles for a minute. We'll get to that in a second. Okay, so I've got a nice layer of watered down PVA on there. Don't forget to get your edges as well. And then I'm going to be a bit ruthless with my flock. Right, so let's have a bit of high tone in there. Couple of little spots, and then I'm just going to douse it with the mid-tone. Okay. Right, now I'm going to do that to both sides. Now just quickly before I carry on with this sort of off camera, what we're going to do to it, just to add a little bit more life to it, is get some flock in between these cobbles here. So like pick out where you want it to go. So I'm going to have a little line of it there. Maybe it comes down to here. If you want, put a bit of washing up detergent in your PVA and that'll help it flow a bit better. But I should have emptied some out into the lid. Put some in there. Get rid of that big jar. And then this time don't douse it like I did with the side. Just sprinkle a little bit on top just so it covers the PVA. Okay, so I'm going to do the other side, let both of these dry, and I'll come back when it's ready. Okay, see you in a sec, guys. Okay, so just to finish this cobblestone off, I'm just going to take a couple of some grass tufts and place them. Oh, sticking to my finger. Place them across the sides, and it'll just add an extra sort of 3D element to it. A couple there. And let's put one there. And one there. Okay, we're not going to put any on the on this one because there's enough green already. Okay, so there's your cobblestone road. It's looking nice and pretty. And then there is your square cobblestone road. Yeah, don't they look good? Okay, so I'll put a few pictures up and we'll set up for the long shot. So I'll see you first. See you in a sec. And there we have our roads. I hope you've enjoyed this week's episode and you've taken something useful from it. Check out my Facebook page, World of 28mm, and feel free to share any of your projects on there. I'm always up for seeing what other people are doing. Yeah, the usuals. Don't forget to like it if you like it. Share everything anyone else would like to see it. And don't forget to subscribe for the next episode. Okay, have fun, guys.